Now let's talk about visualization libraries and functions. And we're going to actually use three different libraries for visualization, namely Matplotlib, Pandas, and Seaboard. As I said earlier, Matplotlib and Pandas are already installed on your computer. If you install Python through Anaconda, so you don't need to install them anymore. But for Seaborn, you have to install Seaborn. And as a reminder, in this video, I'm going to go over the Matplotlib, and we're going to make separate videos for Pandas visualization and Seaborn. Just keep in mind that I'm not going to go over the details of each of these libraries when it comes to visualization, because as we mentioned earlier, it's basically endless. You know, the amount of things that you can do when it comes to visualization, it's huge. So for that reason, we're gonna skip the details. I basically will introduce these things in a very high level to you guys. And during the semester, when I need any of those plots specifically, we're gonna talk a little more about those plots, right? So let's start with the Matplotlib, and then we'll move on to Pandas and Seaborn visualization. Okay. So for Matplotlib, we need to import the library Matplotlib, and we're going to import one of the modules from the library, which is called PyPlot. So if I do import Matplotlib.PyPlot, this is a module within this library. You know, library can be a combination of lots of modules, right? And if I import the entire library, it's going to take a lot of memory from my computer. So in order to save some memory, we're going to say that from this library, import only this module, and we're going to import the entire thing as PLT. From now on, when I type PLT, it's going to basically import this part, matplotlib.pyplot. Okay, it's importing the module, this module, and as you can see, it's not done with the cell yet. There's this star sign here, which means that this cell is not being run yet. So if you see something like this, because importing a library shouldn't take that much long, so most probably something is going on. It's a good idea to restart your kernel. So say restart your kernel, and then let's run it again. Let me see what's running behind the scene. So yeah, Matplotlib is already running as a kernel. So we just restarted that kernel, and now let's run this cell again. Yeah, that was fast, right? So again, if you saw that your computer is kind of stuck in running a cell, most probably you need to restart the kernel. So this is the way that we did that, right? So restart a kernel and then run this line again. It should be very fast to just import a module like this as a PLT. Okay. Here we are going to, because we're using Jupyter Notebook, we don't need to all the time type plt.show at the end of each plot. Because automatically it will show that plot for us in the Jupyter Notebook or Jupyter Lab. But if you're using other kind of editors, so for example, if you're doing PyCharm or things like that, as far as I know, it's been a while that I haven't used PyCharm or other editors. You have to use plt.show to make sure that you will see the PLT as a separate figure, right? Okay, so before doing that, let me actually show you what is inside this PLT. If I do PLT dot, press tab. So these are the things that we can do with that, right? And it has something to do with with plotting things, right? So you will see arrow, you'll see annotation. You can add text, you can change the scale, you can add axes, you can add horizontal line, vertical line, you name it, right? You know, as you can see, bar, box plot, you know, scatter plot, and lots of plots, right? Again, as I said, there are tons of things that you can do with the PLT file and PLT module itself, right? So let's delete this cell. We're going to import NumPy as well, because we're going to go over an exercise together. So let's say import NumPy as NP, and let me actually split these two cells. Oops, sorry. Okay, so let's import NumPy as NP. We're going to say we have X and Y. X is basically, we're looking at a linear space of between minus 5 and 5. We're going to divide it into 20 sections, right? 20. So between minus 5 and 5, just to split it to 20 sections. So, and again, just put it in the X. And Y is simply X to the power of 2 plus 1, we want to plot that, for example. So this is going to be my X, this is going to be my Y. And for PLT, the most common function that we're going to use is PLT.plot. So basically plot something for me. And by default, it's going to plot a line for you. And so it says that, okay, give me the X, give me the Y, and what's the color? Now let me actually pull up the contextual help. You see the first element is X, the second element is Y, okay? So basically these are the arguments. And if you scroll down, see some examples, it says that it's X and Y, okay? So plot X versus Y. If I go ahead and run this line, so this is going to be my plot. Now, do you see there's this line here? I can already see the plot, but if you don't like this line itself there, you can do PLT show, PLT.show. If I do PLT show, so there's going to be only this plot, okay? All right, and then we can, then there are tons of things we can do with the plot itself, right? Actually, I'm gonna go ahead and pull up the documentation for the Matplotlib, and we will navigate through different charts that we can do using Matplotlib. All right, so for example, another example is that we wanna plot X and Y. Now we're gonna use blue line, it's broken, so it's, so the previous one was red, now it's blue, and you're using dashed lines. So you can change the X label by do PLT X label. You can change the Y label doing PLT Y label, and you can add a title. And these are the things that we can do, okay? And for example, we can have two plots and plot them at the same time. So if you want to do something like that, we have to use the subplot, right? So first of all, let's say I want to save everything in an object, call it fig, F-I-G, right? So basically I say that, okay, let's define a PLT figure. I can change the fig size. Fig size is, this is the length, this is the height. So basically let's call this length, this, let's call this height. And this is the size 10x4, and I'm going to make two subplots. So I do PLT subplot. This 1, 2, 1 means that, so go to the first row, then second column, and this is plot number one. So basically it's gonna say that we have one row, two columns. This is plot number one. What is plot number one? X and Y use red dash. What is plot number two? Y and X use green and star and dash, right? So then we can look at the plot. So here's our plot size, okay? And if you wanna save this plot, again, because we have defined it as fig up here, we can go ahead, let me actually pull up this folder. We can go ahead and save it as myfig.png, right? So we can save it as PDF as well. So we are gonna look at the documentation. There are lots of different outputs that you can get from Matplotlib. If I go ahead and say fig.savefig, and then basically you give it a name, because I'm not saying C colon backslash or things like that, it's going to go to the directory that this notebook is already open, right? So if I run this line, there's going to be my fig generated if I double click on it. So this is basically a PNG file, right? I could have done JPG file and et cetera. Okay, so that's basically the gist of Matplotlib. Again, I just wanted to show you at the very high level what Matplotlib does. And now we can quickly take a look at the documentation for that. Guys, as I said, at least when it comes to plotting, I really don't expect you to memorize anything, because first of all, once in a while, new package will come in and it will see that how easier it is to plot things in a newer library or package, okay? And secondly, there is, again, this is my personal opinion, it's not very useful to memorize all these things. The better idea is that the ones that you're going to use frequently will become, you know, naturally you will memorize them. So don't try to, you know, say, you know, basically, I don't want to use the word waste, but misuse your brain memory to memorize all this stuff. Okay. So for example, and whatever you want to plot, just Google it, right? How to do a box plot using Matplotlib. Google it, go to Stack Overflow, see what are the codes, what are the examples. Come to the documentation of the libraries themselves. So for example, this is a documentation for the Matplotlib, and you can literally see, again, tons of things. So for example, if you wanna do line plots, so you go to, I don't know, these are the templates, right? you can see if I want to do box plot, what should I do? If I want to do, I don't know, histogram. So this is how we can do histogram. So let's for example, look at the histogram. So here's an example. And here's a code for you. So it says that do these things, for example, import matplotlib.mlab as mlab and then plt. Then you can scroll down, see basically how they are doing things, right? And let's see. So that was basically, you can go to the gallery. Let me show you maybe another example. Let's do bar demo. So these are, again, you can, if any of these things that you want to work with, you can click on that and see what is the function that you're using, right? So going back to the notebook, so for example, you can do histogram by doing PLT hist, you can do box plot by doing PLT box plot, you can do scatter by doing PLT scatter, and you name it, right? All right, so in the next one, we're going to talk about pandas visualization. Okay, see you in the next one.